Hi, everybody. I'm Thomas from Backscatter. And in this video, I'm going to cover how to use the Backscatter TTL trigger with Sony cameras. We'll take a look at the flash and camera settings needed to use the TTL trigger and advanced settings and features. For an overview on how the TTL trigger works and installation, watch our Backscatter TTL trigger review, or if you're an Olympus OM system user, see our specific setup guide for those cameras. Both videos are linked below. So let's jump in and check out how to use the Backscatter TTL trigger for Sony cameras. First, let's set up the hybrid flash for TTL shooting. The Backscatter TTL trigger for Sony cameras is only TTL compatible with the hybrid flash using the smart control modes. Also, if you're using a lens adapter in order to use Canon EF lenses, make sure you're using models from Metabones, as the Sigma MC11 adapter will not accurately communicate TTL to the camera. This is the case for all TTL systems using the Sigma MC11 and Canon lenses. The hybrid flash can be configured to work with either Olympus OM system or Sony TTL. By default, it is set to Olympus OM system TTL displayed by a blue test indicator light. However, it can be easily switched to Sony TTL, which is indicated by a white test indicator light. You only need to change the mode once, as the hybrid flash will remember the camera brand chosen until you change it again. To change the hybrid flash's mode, first make sure the flash is off with batteries installed. Then press and hold the mode button. While holding the mode button, turn the power dial to SC and remain holding the mode button until the main indicator and test lights start blinking, then release. Next, press the mode button to change the camera brand from the default of Olympus OM system blue to Sony white. Then set the red dial to +2 if you're using all cameras but the A7 R5, and +1 if you're using the A7 R5. Once complete, press the test button to confirm your selection. To use TTL with the hybrid flash, the hybrid flash will need to be set to either SC or SC macro mode. SC mode is perfect for wide angle or general photography, while the SC macro tailors the flash output specifically for macro photography. Now, let's make sure our camera is set to use TTL. To enable TTL, make sure wireless flash is set to off, which is the default on the camera. To check if wireless flash is set to off, you'll need to locate it in the menu. The wireless flash setting is typically found in the exposure color menu. The Sony TTL trigger can fire the hybrid flash in most third-party optical strobes manually. To do this, set your strobe to manual mode. Next, go into the camera's menu and change wireless flash from off to on. Here's a pro tip. If you find yourself changing between TTL and manual using the hybrid flash, you can assign wireless flash to a custom button. This makes switching from TTL to manual a breeze, since it could be done at the push of a button rather than hunting through the menu. Also, if you plan on shooting manual, we recommend turning learning mode off on the hybrid flash. Learning mode is the hybrid flash's automatic pre-flash cancellation system, in which the hybrid flash learns and cancels out pre-flashes that occur before the main syncing flash. We cover this in our learning mode video, which you can find on our hybrid flash how-to and setup guides, which we will link below. Now, let's get nerdy and check out some of the advanced settings and features using the Backscatter Sony TTL trigger. The hybrid flash uses in-camera flash compensation to conveniently brighten or darken your image when shooting in SC or SC macro mode. This allows you to have more creative control over the style of your image while taking advantage of the accuracy and consistency of TTL. You can brighten the image by adjusting the flash compensation in the positive direction for a high key style, or you can darken it for a moodier look by moving it in the negative direction. Here's a pro tip. If you plan on using flash compensation frequently, assign it to a custom button for easy access. Next, we'll talk about high-speed sync, or HSS. HSS allows the camera to sync with a flash beyond its native flash sync speed limit, up to 1/8000th of a second. Using HSS, you can shoot shallow depth of field macro shots with a black background due to the higher shutter speeds. To enable HSS on your Sony camera, you need to set the shutter type to mechanical shutter. If your camera has an electronic front curtain shutter, make sure to turn it off. The hybrid flash can use HSS through either the SC modes with the wireless flash off, or its dedicated HSS mode with the wireless flash on. The Mini Flash 2 and third-party strobes, such as the Retro Pro Max, will use their own HSS modes when wireless flash is set to on. If you are generally shooting in SC mode using the hybrid flash, HSS is activated once you exceed your flash sync speed limit, such as 1/250th with the A7 R5 or 1/400th with the A1. Please note, once the flash sync speed has been exceeded and HSS is activated, the hybrid flash is no longer firing in TTL. If you prefer manual shooting with the hybrid flash and want to use HSS, first change the hybrid flash's mode from manual to HSS. The camera will then automatically engage HSS once you exceed the flash sync speed limit. These same settings can be applied to the Mini Flash 2 in HSS mode or third-party strobes like the Retro Pro Max. Here's a pro tip when using the hybrid flash with HSS. The flash has only one power level in HSS mode. To control exposure, adjust your shutter speed. This lets you brighten or darken your image without ever needing to adjust the flash power. It's super convenient and your hand never leaves the housing. The Mini Flash 2 can only use the top three power levels in HSS, but we typically use the same technique using the highest power output. Well, that was everything you need to know about using the Backscatter TTL trigger for Sony cameras. You're all set to use super accurate automatic flash exposures or get creative with HSS. If you have any questions, call or email us and we'll be happy to help out. Remember, your purchases from Backscatter or any of our authorized dealers help us keep making more of these videos. We have free lifetime tech support on every purchase. We ship every day, and we dive, shoot, and service everything that we sell. This is Thomas from Backscatter, and I'll see you next time.